And you can remain being seated in this place. So I go to the 8th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy. And I'm going to read the King James Version, but it will say the same thing almost as to what you have. Go to the 8th chapter and go to the 11th verse. Go to the 11th verse. And let me read it to you. Beware that you do not forget the Lord your God, by not keeping his commandments, his judgments, and his statutes, which I command you today. Now I want to talk about, for very few moments this morning, if you don't mind, the message entitled, Don't Forget Where All Your Blessings Come From. Is that all right? Don't forget where all your blessings come from. Xavier, your wife will join this church soon. Don't forget where all your blessings come from. Don't forget. Class reunions, scrapbooks, photo albums, familiar songs and old neighborhoods, old friends, all of them have a way of awakening our memories. And not only does it awaken, it has a way of just stirring up our emotions. And when you look at your past, the past is a kaleidoscope of promises. But also during that same period of time, you have some failures. You have had some victory. But along with victories, you've had some embarrassing moments. And sometimes, we want to forget some things that we remember. And the reason being is because they're too painful. And I got some folk in here this morning. You are in recovery. That he recalls ancestral promise.
process. And Exodus deliverance. I got somebody in here this morning. You ought to thank God for deliverance. For Deuteronomy deals with retelling events experienced by people that were at Sinai. Those that were in the wilderness, they looked forward to the time of the promise. And beyond, I want to find somebody this morning that God promised you something. It had to ride here. But you learned how to hold on to the promise. I want to say a couple of things about Deuteronomy. The Deuteronomy is a pivotal book because it involves an interpretive lens. Deuteronomy, I like the book because Deuteronomy makes you look retrospective. It makes you look introspective. But it also gives you a prospective look. It makes you look backwards. It makes you look at where you are right now. But also, it gives you some hope of what tomorrow looks like. Deuteronomy, which means the second law, comes from a Greek translation of the Hebrew phrase, which means copy of the law. Deuteronomy repeats and recasts various matters that had already been talked about. Like at Sinai, in the wilderness, wandering, and in the well. And many times, God has to let you look back in order to appreciate where you are this moment. And no sense you crabbing up on me this moment. Because if you didn't have a past, you could never appreciate your present. And then benefit from your future. Deuteronomy, Moses' book, upper discourse, desert discourse. Matter of fact, I hate to tell you, but Moses at this time was 120 years old. Well, I'm sure you get to be 120. You ought to have a whole lot to say. Wrong thing. You get to be 120. Man, that ain't good enough. You get to be 50. Ta-ta. You ought to have a whole lot to look back at. This book of Deuteronomy. Written in the form of a treaty between a king and his vassals, a typical of the circumcision in the court. It calls Israel to remember who God is. Not only that, it calls Israel to remember what God has done. Lacking faith, the old generation had been wandering for 40 years. They left Egypt and behind them, but they never knew the promised land. But I want to tell you something that is very important. 11-day journey. Wrong place. Till 40 years. 11-day journey. what should have took you 11 days. Amen. Ends up being a 40-year journey.
Next to you, come on, yeah.